You've reached Ryan Singer. I'm busy trying to come up with a name for my debut stand-up comedy CD, so just leave me a message after the beep. I'll get back to you. Thanks.
Ryan, this is Dave. I just wanted to name your album Self-Sabotage. I mean, yeah. Or what? Career Suicide? Hey, this ain't mainstream. Really? You bought this? Those are all good names. Did I sound like a douche?
Hey, Ryan, it's Alex Stone, yeah, and I was just doing some thinking about how you said that you still haven't thought of a name for that CD that you are recording soon, and I actually did some research, and I found out that, like, a lot of comedy CDs are named after, like really good jokes or, like, signature bits, you know what I mean? So I was thinking, like, you should do that with your CD, right? And some of the names that I thought of, you know, off the top of my head were, like Ryan Singer! Might be a redneck, you know, because that was a pretty famous one. That was pretty successful. You could do that one. What else? Ryan Singer. Fuck shoes, because, you know, fuck them. I know you feel that way personally. Ryan Singer, and the 7 words you can never say on TV, because that was a good one. People like that one a lot. Oh, and also, you know, you've never been on TV, so that one kind of works on a couple different levels. It's subversive. I don't know if I use that word right. I mean, you could use the names of one of your own jokes or bits, but yeah, I think we're all on the same page with that one.
Ryan, this is the dance floor calling. I want you to name your album The Freakin' Weekend. Do it!
Hey, Ryan, it's Jeff Tate. I don't know what you should name your CD. I haven't heard it yet. I probably won't. I just don't have any interest. I can't even imagine what you're going to put on this album. Do you even have an hour? Is it going to be an hour long, or is it going to be a half hour? Are you going to release just a half hour of stand-up, disappoint everyone on iTunes who pays full price for half an album? Is that your plan? Or are you going to do a half hour of stand-up and then have the rest be filler skip bullshit? Maybe that's what you should call it. If that's what your plan is, that's a good title. Filler skip bullshit. Hey, thanks for coming to the show, everybody. I'm Ryan. I'll be out front selling my album, Filler Skip Bullshit. It's $10 or whatever you want, really. All right. See you later, buddy.
Ryan? This is Tara. Okay, so you know me. We hung out last night, if that's what you want to call it. But we had intercourse, and I think I'm pregnant. I'm pretty. I think I have 4 babies in me from you, and I just, like, I don't appreciate, like, the things that you said, and, like,
Hi, Ryan. This is Beverly D'Angelo from Fashion Painting Book, P.O. Box 1713, Department L, Delay Beach, Florida, 33444. I think you should name your album The Rising Cock and the Sunset. Please give me a call back at your earliest convenience. I love you.
Hey, Ryan, it's Reed. I have some album title ideas. Let's go. Okay, first, I was thinking you'd call your album LGB Tyrannosaurus Rex. It's kind of like a dinosaur, but a little bit more gayed up. I think that'd be good for you. Number 2, Vasectomy Bear. This lends itself to a good album cover to me. You could just, you know, have a bear with some surgical gloves tying a man's vas deferens. I like it, personally. I only have one more. I was thinking, Is It Your Mind or Your Train? Subtitle, Choo Choo Chuckles. And this really helps you tap into that Lionel Thomas the Tank Engine crowd you were going for. And you could even use the same album cover as before, except now that bear is on a train. which lends itself to more unstable vasectomy. Tell me what you think. I will talk to you later. Goodbye.
You told me. I have your number, and I'm gonna call you when I get my, when I get the sonograms. And when I'm gonna tell my parents, and like my aunts and uncles, and then I'll call you, but I just, I don't know.
Ryan Singer, Mike Cody. We met once or twice at that one party. Hey, buddy, heard the good news that you got a CD coming out very soon. I wanted to call you up and offer you two things. First, my congratulations. Second, professional management. That's right, buddy. I want you to be the star player of my brand new production company, Unlimited Star Power Productions, a division of Make It Happen Entertainment. Now, Ryan, you may be saying to yourself, what exactly can Unlimited Star Power Productions, a division of Make It Happen Entertainment, do for me? Let me tell you something, baby. I open doors. I close particular windows. I offer a 10% discount at participating area Chick-fil-A restaurants. You know something, buddy? I already got your first gig lined up for you. This Tuesday, Jonesboro, Arkansas. You're going to be co-headlining with a local city councilman who does a 20-minute bit about muffins. Figure to be a good fit for you, seeing as you've already got that one bit where you're like, and then the one cookie does it to the other cookie, and it gives birth to the racist joke. I don't know, I never really pay attention. Pays $45, no hotel. Why? Because Ryan Singer doesn't need a hotel room. All you need to do is lock your wolf-like buttery eyes on some local cum rag, and she will offer her bed to you for the evening, because I believe in you. Bottom line is, buddy, Ryan J. Singer plus Unlimited Star Power Productions equals call me. Hey, can I get free tickets to the CD taping?